नमस्कार दोस्तों, हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज राफी फ्रॉम प्लग इन इंडिया एंड वी आर हियर इन पुणे एट द कराडी शोरूम ऑफ क्विक मोटर्स ओकिनावा इलेक्ट्रिक स्कूटर्स एंड मिस्टर अर्थ डीलर हैज काइंडली गिवन अस एन ओकिनावा प्रेज टू टेस्ट राइड एंड फाइंड आउट अबाउट इट. इट्स अ वंडरफुल स्कूटर. वी बीन हियरिंग अ लॉट अबाउट इट. देयर हैज बीन अ लॉट ऑफ बज ऑन द इंटरनेट एंड फाइनली वी आर गोना गिव यू अ क्विक रिव्यू. This is not a full test with a range, but it's a quick review. So here we go. So everyone has been super excited about the Okinawa Praze, and with every comment our excitement grew as well, and finally here it is, the Okinawa Praze, a quick review by Plug In India. And we've driven it around Pune city, we've come to Magarpatta, we've tried out all the modes, the economy, the sport, the turbo boost, and thoroughly enjoyed the bike. It is good quality stuff. I do not think it will ever fail you. The accessories are good quality, the design, the look, the feel, everything. And let's talk about these things a little bit more in detail. The Okinawa Praze, what does it cost? That's the first question people ask, and the answer is 71,888 in Pune. Licensing, registration, GST tax, everything on road. This variant comes with a lead acid battery. It is 72 volts, 48 ampere hours. And that is amazing, because the higher the voltage, the lower the current, the better the electronics, the more optimized your ride. The entire battery weighs around 78 kilos. So right now you only have the lead acid option. The lithium ion flavor is going to be coming out in a few months, and that's really something to look forward to. Just before this, we had reviewed the Ridge, which had a a coil suspension, and this one has a gas suspension in the rear. And you have a telescopic gas suspension in the front, and definitely the travel is a lot more, which means that it can take better shocks. None of the speed breakers even came close to touching us, even while pillion riding, two of us heavy people, and I think that was amazing. It's built for Indian roads. Having said that, I did find that the Ridge had a better ride quality. Despite being a better suspension, I think maybe you could adjust it so that it would give you a bit of a smoother ride. There is that bit of a recoil from this suspension. Right, so now we'll talk about parking. It's got two stands. It's got a side stand and it's got a rear stand. Side stand is very nice, easy to use, quite comfortable. It's a good, decent angle. The bike will not fall over either side, and I'm happy with that. It's got a good spring, and however, the rear, the main stand, which one assumes that most of the people do not use, but that is the thing that you should use when you're parking your bike overnight, and which gives it stability, is very hard. It doesn't seem to be at the center of gravity. The bike doesn't come on quite easily. And I suppose we should give you a demo. So it's quite a throw to get it onto the main stand. I have been riding a Royal Enfield Bullet all my life, and even that 200 kilo Bullet was easier to put onto the stand than this one. Oh, okay. And it's not because of the weight, it's because of the balance and the positioning of the stand. It could be better. Most of the other e-bikes we've tested in the market have an issue overtaking even simple things like rickshaws and cycles. I have not experienced that with this bike, especially since it's got these three modes, and when I really want to overtake, I can go into sport mode, I can put on turbo and I can really overtake and come back to economy to preserve battery to extend my range. And doesn't matter which mode I am in, I do not feel that the bike is less powerful. So that way, it's only the top speed which is limited, but not the torque, not the power, and the same acceleration profile, the same gentle acceleration. So this is right now in economy mode. What we would do is go into sport mode but just by flipping the switch if you've reached more than 35-36 kilometers per hour. And while it's in sport mode, if you were to press the turbo button, which is right here, then it would give you an additional 20 kilometers per hour worth of speed. Alright, so as far as efficiency, battery economy is concerned, we've been told that in eco mode, it'll give you a good 125 kilometers at regular speed, not going too slow, at the top speed. And the sport mode would give you about 90 kilometers. And if you are to use the turbo mode about 4 to 5 times, it'll drop it down to 85 kilometers. So the worst case scenario is an 85 kilometer range with you reaching the top speed almost all the time, and the best case is 125 with you reaching the top speed almost all the time. If we were not to go at top speed, it will probably give you a much better range. So this the Praise has a lead acid battery from a company called Amptech.
You can see that,
and yes, it's visible, Amptech over here. And look at the massive 1000 watt BLDC motor over here. You can, it's got a little bit heated up after our riding. Warrantied for 1 year, and right now that's the only variant you have, that 48 ampere hour 72 volt battery. And yes, it should give you a good 2 years worth of life, after which the battery will need to be replaced. The charger, and it's a 6.5 ampere 72 volt DC output. It'll take anywhere from up to 220 volts. It doesn't say the range, but yeah, it's a 700 watt charger, and it'll take 10 to 12 hours for a full charge. But I don't think anybody is going to discharge it completely. You could just probably top it up every night, and it won't take so long. Oh, definitely, yeah. You don't want to go all the way to zero. You want to run it between say 50 to 75, or you know, somewhere in between. Yeah, it'll take 3.5 units of electricity for a full charge. A wonderful feature that we've discovered in the Okinawa Praise is it has a reverse assist mode. And if I'm on a slope like so, and I want to move back, I just gently push, and I can feel that the Praise's motor is, it's actually going now. Check it out. Now I'm trying to balance. It's a slow speed, but yes, it's assisting me in backing up. This is the easiest reverse. I think this is an award-winning feature. I would never want reverse on an accelerator. It can cause horrible accidents. But when I'm pushing, oh my God, this is awesome. I came up that entire slope without effort. Back from our test ride, and we had a great time. Hence the whoop. And you've got a couple of colors over here. You've got a purple, you've got a blue, gold on the poster. Okay. So let's talk about the controls, the switches. I certainly think they've put good quality stuff over here. It's a nice, decent accelerator. You've got a good switch. This horn button is certainly extra because I'd have to have a bigger thumb. It's not that comfortable, but this is an extra thing. And this is the right, I suppose I would use this horn much more. You've got your turn indicator, you've got a turbo switch, and the high beam, low beam indicators. You've got your three different off running lights and headlights buttons. The brake levers are nice and firm. It gives you a good feel, and definitely the disc brakes do kick in quite soon. So a couple of unique features in the Praise. First of all, you've got keyless entry, and one wonders why this piece of metal is required. But yes, this is required for the dickey and for the handle lock. But as far as ignition is concerned, here goes. Alright, so it turns blue and then it's on. That's lovely. Unlock one, okay.
Perfect.
Alright. Full day's ride at Pune in heavy city traffic, zigzag and no lane discipline. One has discovered a couple of things. What happens is that at 35 kilometers it tops out in eco mode. And then to overtake or zigzag or move anywhere, I need to switch the flip the switch and go into sport mode. And then it again tops out in the next 10-15 kilometers. And then to go further, I need to then push the turbo. And this is cumbersome. Like in the middle of traffic, you've got tick, tick, tick. So what if the accelerator itself would handle it? Like it reaches full speed and I keep on accelerating. So then it should automatically shift to the next higher power mode. So this is definitely related to the controller. It's related to the controller settings. It's related to the fine tuning that the designer has done for this particular logic controller, which informs the BLDC motor what to do. So it's not a limitation of the BLDC motor per se. It's the design entire, and it's a conservative design. It's meant for people who don't zip and zap and zoom. It increases your battery life. It gives you fantastic ride quality. It gives you everything. Alright, so switching between all these modes is quite cumbersome. I would just probably just leave it on eco and let it be at that. And then I will have to suddenly actively start switching modes from E to S and T and all that. And there are quite a few buttons, so it takes some learning curve. Trick would be how to get this to be as responsive as a single smooth acceleration. And my answer is a gearbox. You probably need a gearbox. So yeah, and so a mid-drive with a gearbox would absolutely kill it. You could have the same setup in this exact form factor. Everything else would be the same. You would have to modify a few things, of course, but we have had so much hype about the Okinawa, and definitely we've checked them out, we've met the people, we've seen the designs, and Okinawa has upped the ante. It's raised the bar. All of the other players will now have to do better, and we are very happy with that. And yes, definitely it could go a lot higher, and that's what we want. We don't want electric bikes which are a poor second cousin to ICE bikes. We want electric bikes in all their glory, and that in our opinion is a bar which is much higher than ICE vehicles. So that can definitely be achieved.